years ago this month, we planted our church. And 1 year ago this month, we became Heights Church. And what's so significant about our name is that it's not just a name, but it's also an aspiration. Because we have set our hearts on walking life at the side of Jesus. And we aspire to nothing less. And in humility, we know that there is no greater invitation that we could say yes to. And at our 1 year mark of Heights Church, we look back on a very challenging year where truly the lows were so low and the pain was so real. And yes, sometimes we felt desperation for the long moment that we have all been in. And then Jesus would do the unexpected. And the high of that experience was so high. Well, it's been an astounding year, no doubt about it. And it's one where God's hand has had to lead us one day at a time, or we would have not survived the journey arriving here today. Truthfully, it reminds me of when the people of God were being led out of Egypt. They had to go through a Red Sea, which, well, it wasn't supposed to part. And they were being led into a wilderness that offered them little or nothing. And yet God was found to be abundantly good. And before they entered the promised land, God told them, he challenged them, don't forget how well you've been cared for by me. And the reason for that is because he wanted them to know who is your source. Don't forget, remember how well I cared for you in difficult, desperate, and challenging times. Look back and remember how miraculously well we walk together. But unfortunately, they did forget. I don't know how you forget the Red Sea parting. I don't know how you forget the pillar of cloud which guided them by day. It was the presence of God in front of them, visible. I don't know how you forget about that. The pillar of fire, which was the visible presence of God by night. I don't know how you forget about that. I don't know how you forget about the hand of God guarding them against people who wanted to harm them. But you know what? They did. They forgot these things. But as we gather today and we recognize 1 year as Heights Church, 12 years as our church has been planted, we don't want to forget what God's done for us. We remember that he and he alone is our source, and we don't want to ever forget that. And we want to remember that Jesus, through this whole time, has been faithful to show us exactly what to do and how to be. How many times has he pulled us aside as a church and as individuals to say, now listen, we're about to walk into this room. We're about to have this conversation with this group of people. Let's remember who we are. We walk into that room as the people, the ones who will love God with all of our heart, mind, soul, and strength. And we're going to love the people in that room as we would want to be loved. Jesus is so faithful to show us what our mission and our purpose is each and every day. I love that God has been so faithful as he has been our source. And today is the day that we get to stand on the high ground and take a measure of really how far we've come. We get to see where we've come from, and we get to see the Jesus path forward. And I love the words of Paul found in 2 Corinthians where he says about this mission and this purpose that we have. He says, we now have this light shining in our hearts, but we ourselves are like fragile clay jars containing this great treasure. And it makes clear that our great power, this great power that's inside of us, it's from God, not from ourselves. But listen to this part. We are hard pressed on every side by troubles, but we are not crushed. We are perplexed, but we are not driven to despair. And we are never abandoned by God. And we get knocked down, but we are not destroyed. And as we arrive at this summit today, we arrive as His living story, knowing why we're here. It's those moments that Jesus pulls us aside and says, you know, this next room we're about to enter into, this next season we're about to enter into, these next conversations we're about to enter into, let's know why we're here. It's to be the ones who show that we love God with all of our heart, mind, soul, and strength, and that we love others as we would want to be loved. 1 year ago, we took a look at a person who was called to the high places and he wanted to go. Now, I didn't say he was called to distant, unapproachable places. No, it's as Jesus said in John chapter 15, verse 19, you're in this world, but you're not of this world any longer. That person's name was Habakkuk, and he heard the voice of God calling him as well as the people of God in his generation to walk with him at higher places so that they could rise and see where they've come from, but also the path forward that God had for them. Here's what it says in Habakkuk 3:17. God, the Lord, is my strength. He makes my feet like the deer's, and He makes me tread on high places. I love the visual of the high places. It absolutely meant something to them. The high places were places they would go above the chaos, above the best ideas of what was happening in the lower valleys. At the high places, you have peace for those who are hunted and having others chasing them constantly. Well, they're able to turn around and they're able to see the enemy coming from afar off. And they could prepare themselves for what's going on. God's able to show them how they are to respond from the high place. It's an amazing vantage point to be at. And that's what God was telling Habakkuk and his generation. And it's also what He's telling us when He calls us to the high places. Aspiring to the high places is about moving from weakness to strength. That's where we want to be as Heights Church. The truth is, Jesus did not go to a cross so that you and I could continue to live in the lowlands, the chaos of the world, driven by the fear and the anxiety and the uncertainty of the day, or to be left to the whims of the powers of this world. The scriptures say that Jesus defeated the powers of this world. And that's not a ceasefire. That's not a negotiated treaty. That is a sound defeat. That's what Jesus did. And He calls us to rise above them instead of staying in the lowlands, hanging out with all of those who are still being driven by the whims of those powers. No. We want to live above that. And as Jesus said, you are in this world, but you are not of this world any longer. God is my strength, Habakkuk says. He is my strength. He makes my feet like the deer. He makes me tread on my high places. It's here at the high place that inspires my faith to emerge. When I stand here, I can begin to see with faith what God wants for my family. And I wonder, as we stand here today, what is it that God is calling out of your family? It's going to require faith. But what is it? What does He want? It's time for us to say yes to the Jesus path forward. What does He want for you at your place of work? What does He want for you with your neighbor? What is it that He wants for you from your friends? God's got something that He would say, if you would lean into it with faith, you and I could walk and do miraculous things together. At the high place, our faith emerges. It's also here that my faith is inspired to follow His way. Because each one of these things that God's calling us to, He has a way for us to go there as well. It's not just meet me there. It's let me show you step by step how we are going to get there. And it's here at the high place that we experience God's powerful presence. And it literally is going to feed our soul as we are present with Him. And it's here at the high place that I experience God's strength in me. So that when the dust of everything that's up in the air right now settles, we will be found standing strong in our faith in Jesus and Jesus alone. And also here. At the high place, we're going to find our faith in Him. It's only going to grow. And voices from the valley begin to fade, but His voice becomes stronger and stronger and stronger each and every day as we tune our ear to Him, and His one voice begins to make all the difference in our life, and all of these other voices begin to fade away, and we can know exactly what it is that God's calling out of us. Oh yeah, Habakkuk knew exactly what it meant when God was calling him like a deer to the high places. The truth is, the headlines of the day don't tell the story of God. You and I tell the story of God. Well, Habakkuk lived in a day where there were all kinds of headlines as well. All kinds of false peace, false security, false promises. But Habakkuk realized that his source was not going to be those false promises. It would be God and God alone. He would remember what God had done for them, how well they were cared for all those years, and even up to that moment in time, and he would know that God could be trusted with his very life. He longed for something more, as God would call him to friendship at the high place. Habakkuk said, "Yes, that's where I want to go." Oh Lord, Habakkuk says in chapter 3, verse 2, "I have heard the report of you and your work. Oh Lord, do I fear." In other words, awe grips me. "And I've heard about this in the midst of the years. I want you to revive it, God. In the midst of the years, make it known, this incredible report that I have heard about you and what you want to do." Habakkuk is speaking of both his times and our times. He's speaking about the salvation and the rescue of God. But he's also looking forward to the salvation and the rescue of God through Jesus that you and I know all about. You see, it's Jesus who truly makes us tread on our high places. This is where Jesus is taking us. We're on a journey, and it's truly the adventure of a lifetime. And let's not forget why we're here, church. It's so that Jesus can pull us aside and he can say, "Now, this room that we're about to walk into, this season we're about to move into, this group of people we're about to speak to, let's all recognize that we're the ones that are going to go into that room and be the ones who say, we're here to love God with all of our heart, mind, soul, and strength, and to love others as we would want to be loved." That's who we are. That's what he's calling us to at the high places. And when we make this our goal, we cannot go wrong. This is also what Jesus meant when he said, "You are the light of the world. You are a city set on a hill, and it cannot be hidden. In the same way, let your light shine before others so that your good works would be seen and give glory to your Father in heaven. The reality is God's church is meant to be a blaze, a signal fire of hope, a city on a hill, on a high place like this that you can't miss from the valley floor. It is a signal fire of hope that people of our generation in our city and in our own families are going to look to in the person of you as you walk with Jesus at the high place. And as we live out His hope, one person at a time, and all of us collectively as Heights Church, we are going to offer an invitation to our city and our generation to walk with Jesus along with us at the high places. Because God is our strength, and He is the one who allows us to walk at our high places. And here at the high place, we can see where we've come from, and we can see the Jesus path forward. Today, we remember how well we've been cared for, and we remember that God is our only source. It is He who we look to today. We remember and we celebrate You in Jesus' name. And so now, Lord, as we come to this high place at the 12-year mark of our church being planted, at the one-year mark of Heights Church, Lord, we dedicate ourselves to the mission of being those people who walk into every room to love You with all of our heart, mind, soul, and strength, and to love our neighbor. Lord, we want to be that city on a hill. We want to be the signal fire of hope set ablaze. And so, God, we give our lives to You all over again today in dedication. In Jesus' mighty name, amen.